This is the Silver Blood Inn. I'll let you figure out who owns it by yourself.
You aren't with the Forsworn, are you? People say they saw you when the prisoners escaped. So many dead.
My family came here centuries ago. We made a good living smithing the silver that flows through the city. But you probably wanted to know about the fancy carvings and stonework, didn't you? Travelers always do. Here. I have a delivery I need to make to Kalsimo. Why don't you take it to him? He knows the history of Markarth better than anyone. Thank you. He can be a bit difficult, but I'm sure he'll appreciate your help. Let's see what adornments I might have available. Come back if you need a new ring or necklace.
No, I'm not Arnleaf. Oh, a bit of this and a bit of that. Come back whenever you need something.
I'm gonna be a silversmith
like my father,
like my mother
and his father before him.
Silver, friend. Blood and silver. Just turn around and leave the city. That's the smart move.
What?
Why? Are you interested? Kalsimo, is he interested in Feline? That sly old codger. I should have guessed. Good for him. For the both of them. Between you and me, she could use a bit of warmth. As for what she might like, I didn't tell you this. Feline likes to act tough, but she really has a soft spot for, of all things, poetry. You know, I took some classes at the Bard's College as a youth. Poems come in handy when wooing. There's a poem I once used on an older lady of Rorikstead. I can change it to be about Feline, if you've got some gold. Are you prepared to receive my golden words? Wonderful. I'll write it out so you won't forget it. You should probably just take this directly to Feline. Wouldn't want the old ice brain stumbling over the words.
Thank you.
Wait. I know you. Wait. I know you. There's no mistake. You're a wanted man, and it's time to pay for your crimes.
All right, just keep your voice down and don't let me catch you again.
Damn those Forsworn. Think they can kill people in my city? I'll have Madinok's head. The Silverblood family will be hurt.
You! Who are you to approach the Jarl of Marhar? Very well. You may approach the Mournful Throne, but watch your words. Pardon me? I'm not sure what this is all about.
This is lovely. Kalselmo wrote this? About me? I never knew he had such feeling. Clearly, I've never even thought of him in that manner. I wish that I was as skilled with words as he. Here, take in this letter. I may not be as eloquent as he is, but I hope he understands.
Igmund's uncle, as well as his steward. Oh, yes. Thank you. Here you go. Some gold for your assistance and your discretion. I have letters to read.
Madinok has been found to be the true murderer of Markarth. On behalf of the city, I apologize for your wrongful imprisonment. Are you a sellsword? I don't like your kind. No honor, no loyalty, unreliable. But I can't turn away a potential ally in these times. Let's see if you're better than a common mercenary. My scouts have tracked down one of the Forsworn leaders, hiding out in their blood-soaked camps. Deal with them. We will see. It all started here, this rebellion. When the Empire lost the Reach during the Great War, we became desperate. We promised a group of Nord militia free worship in exchange for their help retaking the Horn. Then the Elves found out about it. We were forced to arrest all of them. Ulfric Stormcloak, their leader, used the whole thing as proof that the Empire had abandoned Skyrim. The rebels called it the Markarth Incident. It was the founding day for the Stormcloaks, and where this war really started. The White Gold Concordant, our treaty with the Elves after the Great War, forbids free worship of Talos. But that's what we promised Ulfric and his men. It seems foolish looking back, but at the time we were hoping the Elves wouldn't find out. So when they did find out, it was either we arrest Ulfric and the militia, or enter into yet another war with the Aldmeri Dominion. The choice was clear, and now Ulfric threatens the thinly veiled peace we sacrificed so much for. When the Aldmeri Dominion invaded the Imperial City, the Legion all but turned a blind eye to the other provinces. Many of the disgruntled natives of the Reach used the opportunity to depose the Empire and founded what they called an independent kingdom. It was little more than a chaotic uprising, but the Reach was removed from Imperial authority for 2 years before it reclaimed it. But the leaders of the uprising refused our offers of peace. They fled into the hills and became the Forsworn. Yes, I know. We have some advantages if they come here. The city is built into the mountainside, so it's hard to reach into, even from the skies. And everything is made of stone, even the beds. We'll have no trouble from Dragon's Fire here. I don't know you, and I don't sell what precious property we have to outsiders. But if you're willing to work, and you prove to be reliable, I might deem you worthy to live here. My steward will handle things from there. I want no mercy for the Forsworn. Understand?
As his housecarl, Igmund's security is my chief concern.
Wait, I know you. There are so few pleasures in life as fine as your company.
Wait, I know you. All right then.
Good to see Skyrim. Oh, that's right. I keep forgetting to pick that up. Poor Kira, such a patient woman. Now, you're supposed to get something for your trouble, aren't you? How about some gold? People seem to like that, I notice. This is more than I could have hoped for. Have you really done this for me? I have to see her. Please, excuse me. What? Oh, goodbye.
Wait. I know you.
Pauline, I...
Shh. It's all right. You don't need to say anymore. I had no idea you were so nuanced.
I love you.
So I hear. Come here.
Wait, I know you. There's no mistake. You're a wanted man, and it's time to pay for your crimes. Good enough. I'll just confiscate any stolen goods you're carrying, then you're free to go.
And I paid you 700 gold, man. Greedy son of a bitch. But I'm rich.
I have things to study. What is it?
Stormcloak murdered the High King with his voice.
Heard about you and your honeyed words.
What a waste. There must be a dozen men. Yeah. Kelselvo called in his entire expedition. Said he needed every man he could get to take this message. Better them than us. We lost three good men to the tracks. And for what? Just to see another damn spider tank around.
Wow, that's impressive. Still here. I am at your command. Lead on.
This is Markov, traveler. Safest city in reach. Don't suppose you'd enchant my sword. Dull old blade can barely cut butter. You little filcher. You have committed crimes against Skyrim and her people. What say you in your defense? Smart man. Now.
Aww. Now I have to repick all those cogs. Well, reload and repick all those cogs. That's a bit of a bummer. I'll just get the cogs and get that out of here.
Selmo called in his entire expedition.
That's impressive.
Said he needed every man he could get back to the message.
Still here? How can I serve you, my Thane? I am sworn to carry your burdens. You lead. I'll follow.
It's hard for a thief to resist the temptation. Amulet of Talos. Nice. Still need that shrine, you know, in my little house.
You're not supposed to be in here. You're not supposed to be in here.
Wasn't I supposed to find the Fulman book here? do I need for it then? Piece of paper. One second. Let me quickly. Teleport to my house so I can drop the shit in the next episode. Well, touché.
This is Markov, traveler. Safest city in the Reach. You're that one from the college. You heard about it.